subtitle of my talk is actually Video Games for Working Adults. You'll see why in a minute. So quick and dirty definition. Bottom fish, everything that's not salmon or would salmon eat in the water column. All those guys in there except for the guys on the very top there. So one
of my jobs is to try and figure out how many of the bottom fish we have in Puget Sound. And one of the ways we do it is with a boat, with a net that we tow along the bottom. And we capture a lot of stuff and we throw it in a box and we do all kinds of mean, dirty, ugly, nasty things to them and we throw them over the side of the boat. Some of them are dead and some of them are alive, so there's some problems with that technique. The problem with what we do with the boat and the net doesn't really go well with the rocks. And that's where a lot of those guys live, is in the rocks. So we have to come up with better ways to do what we do. And one of the ways to do that is to do visual surveys. So just looking at some of the fish that we look at that live in the rocks, and some of these fish are actually in this tank over here. So we have a couple different species of rockfish, Pacunski and canary and yellow eye. These three fish are on the endangered species list right now, and they're pretty much driving my world. I just came from a meeting in Mount Vernon where we're talking about these fish. But lingcod are pretty popular fish for a recreational fishery. This is a little baby juvenile yellow eye, little guy, turns into this guy. Coolback rockfish, fairly common rockfish in Puget Sound. So all these species are very important, but they don't live on the places that we control. They live in the rocks. And we have to find better ways to count them, because if we don't know how many are out there, we don't know when to say, oh, we've recovered. That light is really bright. So once we know, you know, where to find these fish, then we can figure out ways to go count them. And how do we count them? Well, here's where the video games come in. It's all about toys to me. So this is pretty much what I get to do. A lot of my working time is spent on this boat, playing with this, driving it around to the bottom of Puget Sound. And the beauty of this toy, which is called a remotely operated vehicle, or an ROV, or if you're Canadian, a ROV. The cool thing about this toy is the fact that it's like really fun for me, but we can take it down and we don't really have any time limits. We don't have any depth limits. I can go all the way to the bottom of Puget Sound, which is about 1,000 feet deep. We've been down there, done that. It's really kind of boring. It's all mud down there. The rocks are actually more in the 200 to 300 foot range that tend to be more interesting places to look. It's a lot safer than scuba. And believe me, I love to go diving, but there are places that I just can't go that deep. One of the really cool things about this is it's not lethal. We don't kill anything. We can count fish. We come back and we can see them again. We've actually done that in 2008. We found 4 Pacunski rockfish, and I'm not going to tell you where they are. 4 years later, to the day, we went back out to that exact same spot, to the exact same rock, and guess what we found? 1 Pacunski rockfish, but they're still there. At least one of them was. So we didn't kill anything, and we can go back and count them over and over again. We don't destroy the habitat. The one thing about trawling is when you pull the net across the bottom, you're going to move things around. It changes the substrate. It changes the bottom. But the best part is we can work in the rocks. We can go places that we've never gone before, and it gives us the ability to get at these species that we can't get at with our traditional methods. Thank you, Miles, for the great introduction on multi-beam bathymetry, because this is what we used to know. This is a standard nautical chart. 2 dimensions. There's nothing here to look at. Oh, it says, yeah, it's rocky. Oh, it looks like it might be a little steep here. But, you know, it doesn't really tell us anything. This is Friday Harbor Labs, in case anybody's interested. This is what we know now. Very pretty. Now we know. These are the rocks. Now we go here. Instead of taking the ROV into places where we can actually trawl, we can go here and say, all right, here's where the fish are. And now what we're doing is we're actually, where we find fish, we plot them on these rocks, and now we're developing models where we can say what kinds of attributes the rocks have that tell us where we should find fish. Because you know what? We don't find fish on this side. We find them on this side. They're very specific. So here's where we've been. The San Juans, there's 350 points. There's where we went last year. And here's what we found. And that's what it looks like.